In this video, we're going to review how to create and delete directories, create files, and also make working at the command line a little bit easier. So let's start by looking at what is in my current directory. So if I do a pwd, I find out that I'm at my home directory, and I'll do an ls to list what's in my directory. And what I think I'm going to do is, instead of creating some new folders in here, I'm going to change into my desktop directory, which is the what the GUI in Ubuntu really puts anything I put on my desktop drops into that folder. So let's go into that folder. Now, notice I could type the word desktop if I want, but that's a lot of typing. So one of the things you can do with Bash is there's this thing called command completion. So once you've typed enough of the folder to let the shell know what you mean, you can hit tab. And notice that when I hit tab, the word desktop was auto-completed for me. What would happen if I go back and just type capital D and hit tab? Well, if I'm persistent and hit it a few times, what's going to happen is the shell is going to be like, hey, you know, there are several things in this directory named, that begin with a capital D. But if I give it one more letter, DE for desktop, and hit tab, it auto-completes. So what's really cool is you can save a lot of typing by learning to just start typing the name of the file you want, and then use tab to do auto completion. So now if we look, I'm currently located in my desktop directory. What's here? Well, I have a little shortcut folder here for my terminal so that it's easier for me to launch. But let's start to add some stuff to this directory and play around with it. So the first command we want to do is we want to make a directory. So I'm going to make a directory, and the command to do that is mkdir. And again, it pretty much translates in your brain to make directory. And I'm going to call it a directory called top. And I'll hit enter, and then I'll do ls, and you'll notice that it created a new directory called top. And now I'm going to cd into that directory, hit type t, and hit tab to autocomplete it. And notice now there's nothing in there. I'll make another directory called middle, and let's just see that that exists. Now, last time I created, when I created this middle directory, I cd'd into the top directory, but you don't need to do that, right? I can be in the current directory, and again, I'm currently in the top directory, and I can see the middle directory. So what I want to do is I want to make another directory called bottom inside of the middle directory. So I'm going to say mkdir. I'm going to give the name of the middle directory, hit tab to autocomplete that, and then say bottom. So again, you don't always need to be in the directory in which you're working. With that said, I can say that it's a pretty good habit to get into, to be in the directory that you're working, so that you always know where you're creating files or deleting files from. And now if I look, notice there's no bottom directory in my current directory, but if I do an ls of the middle directory, there's the bottom directory. So we just essentially set up this pretty basic file hierarchy. So I'm currently in the top directory, and I just installed a command into Ubuntu called tree. And so if I type the tree command and give it the current directory, you'll notice that it shows me a file hierarchy. And it says, well, I'm in whatever the name of my current directory is. And inside of middle is a directory called bottom. If I go back up to desktop, just to verify that I'm in desktop, and I type tree, notice that it shows me that in the current desktop directory, there's a file called terminal. Ignore what this means. There's a directory called top, and in that directory is a directory called middle, and in that directory is a directory called bottom. So tree is a useful command. It is not installed by default on Ubuntu 12 LTS. So you know, one of the things that you might need to do is, if you try to use tree, Ubuntu is pretty good about giving you some instructions on how to install it. We'll go over installing applications at a later date. So there you can kind of see the file hierarchy that I have created. So now I want to go in, and I am going to cd into top, and I'm going to cd into middle, and now I'm going to be in the directory called bottom. And what I want to do is I want to create that delete that directory. So to delete a directory, the command is rmdir, which stands for remove directory, and then the name of the directory that I want to remove. And you'll notice that I'm still in the middle directory, but the file or the directory bottom is now gone. So rmdir will remove a directory. But there's a caveat. I'm going to clear the screen. And again, I am in the middle directory. So I'm going to go back up to the top directory. All right, what's in here is middle. Well, let me go up one more to the desktop. So now I'm in the desktop. And again, there's top and terminal. So I'm going to do rmdir top and try and get rid of top and middle together. But what you're going to notice, rmdir is a pretty smart utility in that it will not let you delete a directory unless that directory is empty. And that's really just a safeguard, because what you don't want to do is accidentally delete, say, you know, your entire home directory or an entire website or, you know, anything that, you know, if rmdir didn't stop you when you wanted to delete something that wasn't empty, then that would be a problem. So the way I would resolve this is I would delete the middle directory and then I could delete top. If we take a look at the man page for rmdir, you're probably saying to yourself, well, you know, how can I delete non-empty directories? Well, what you'll notice is that rmdir will only remove empty directories. We'll talk about how to remove full directories too. But once you have that power, it can be a little dangerous. So for right now, we can only delete empty directories. Okay, so next up. Clear the screen, and I'm going to go back into top, and I'm going to put some files in here. We'll talk about using editors next week, specifically VI. We can touch a little bit on using Emacs, but what I want to do is show you just how to create empty text files. And at this point, creating empty text files is just a simple command that you might think, well, why would I ever want to create an empty file? But there's a bunch of reasons why you might want to do that. And we'll talk about that a little bit later when we get into scripting. The command I'm going to use is called touch, and I'm going to create a file called test.txt. You don't need file extensions on Unix, but it's sometimes nice to have them. So there's test.txt. If I look at some information about that file, what we'll notice is that this is a regular file, because there's a dash here at the beginning. We looked at that when we did the ls lecture, and you'll notice that this file has 0 bytes in it, so it's definitely an empty file. The touch command is a useful command for creating empty files. It's also a good command for updating modification dates on files, so you can touch a file so that it looks like it's been accessed more recently than it may have, and there are reasons why you might want to do that. Again, we're going to use touch here just to kind of make some files so that we can delete them. So next up, we want to go ahead and delete that file. So we had rmdir for remove a directory, and I'm going to use rm to remove a file. So if I type rm test.txt and then do an ls, the file's gone. So the rm command allows us to remove files. Let's take a look at the man page for rm, because it comes with a lot of nice features. The ones I'm going to point out that I think are really useful, start with command I, which means every time it goes to remove a file, it'll prompt you and say, do you really want to do this? Unix systems tend to default to being very quiet, so they're not going to say anything. They're going to assume that you want to do what you want to do. So if you like that feedback that you're used to getting from a GUI, the command I option can be helpful. A rather dangerous option, but one that's important to know about, is dash F, which stands for force. And what that will do is, no matter what, it will delete the file. So that can be a little dangerous, and we'll talk about why in a second. There's also one other command that I think is important to take a look at right now, dash R, which stands for recursive. So earlier I said you could not delete a directory unless it was empty using rmdir. So I'm going to create a file in touch, and I'm going to call with touch in the middle directory called deleteme.txt. And if I do ls middle, you'll know that there's a file in there. And again, I'm in the top directory, so I can see the middle directory. So if I do rmdir on middle, you'll notice that it says fail. The directory is not empty, and that's because I just put the deleteme.tx file in. But if I do rm-r and I do middle, it deleted it. So rm can be used to delete directories, and dash-r for recursive can be used to delete basically every folder inside of that folder. But it's a little dangerous, right? Because you want to make sure that you don't lose data. That's why it's always a good idea to use rmdir. In this case, maybe if we added rm-ri for interactive, it would prompt me on everything I wanted to delete. But, you know, if you got a lot of files to delete. So again, you just need to be really careful what you're doing. One of the things that I will mention that's a bad thing, the worst thing, I think there used to be a joke in Windows where everybody would tell people to fix a problem by doing format C colon, which formats your hard drive. You know, it's kind of hard to do this, but the command rm-rf means to forcefully and recursively delete everything underneath the root directory. So this is basically a way that you would you know, if you had the correct privileges, and we haven't talked about privileges yet, but if you were running this command as the root user, which has ultimate privileges on the machine, this would go ahead and pretty much start wiping everything out on your machine. So just be careful. And if anybody ever tells you to do rm-rf, don't listen to them. And it's just a good thing to know. So we looked at making directories. We looked at removing directories. We looked at using rm to delete files. We looked at touch to create files. One thing I'll show you real quick is you can do chaining of commands using semicolons. So let's say I want to make a folder called middle again, and I want to then immediately put a file in there. You can put a semicolon between separate commands on the command line, and it will work. And so then all I'll say is make a new file in here called imnew.txt. And what you'll notice is that those two commands execute immediately. So if I do an ls, there's middle. And if I look at what's in the middle directory, there is the file that I created. So you can do file chaining simply by putting a semicolon between commands. And again, we'll see where this is useful a lot later. It's really helpful when compiling programs, especially the kernel. You can just put all the commands on one line and let it go. So again, if you need to execute multiple commands, just separate them with a semicolon.